Kassia Lueck with ERA Viking Realty. Thank you so much for joining me on another episode of Community Connections, where my goal is to feature local businesses in the Alexandria area along with organizations. Today, I'm interviewing Leanne at Art Bar 39 to see what she has to share. Come on, let's go.
Thank you, Leanne, so much for meeting with me today. I'm so excited to hear about the Art Bar and you in general. Why don't you just tell me a little bit about yourself and what kind of experience that you have in the artist world?
My name's Leanne Larson. I'm the owner and founder of Art Bar 39. And in the experience in the art world that I've had, I went to school for it. Back in 2012, I graduated from the U of M in Morris with a studio art degree. So from the moment I walked across that graduation line, I said, I'm doing this full time. So
when did you know that you were artistic? Was it when you were a little child, or has your passion grown over the years?
It's definitely grown over the years, but I've always been that kid that will doodle on the math project before I turn it in just to get the A in presentation and the C or D and everything else. So
when you're from Australia, correct? Mm-hmm. How long have you been here in the United States? What's your story with that?
Been here 15 years.
Okay.
Coming up in February, nearly 16 actually. And I met my husband when I was a nanny in upstate New York about in 2002. And a couple years later, we ended up getting married. So I moved over here. He wouldn't want to go down there. It was a bit hot for him. But as we get older, we're changing our minds there. So that's how it all started. And we moved to Garfield because his grandparents had a property out there. So we bought the property off them. And that's where we've been ever since.
How did you find the Art Bar? Is it a franchise? How did that come about? Did you get started in that?
I had been teaching in community ed for about a year, 2 years, ever since I graduated in 2012. So teaching was right there. I was already doing it. And my sister-in-law in Rhode Island was like, you've got to do this paint and sip thing because it's huge out here. And I was like, I'm good, you know, because I was doing a lot of commission work and I was pretty busy already. So. But then as time went by, I'm like, you know what, this is awesome. Why not do community ed classes, but add wine to it and just have fun with this? So it started out with a few classes actually at the Depot Express downtown. We did a few up there and I had a little bit of a connection there because I was affiliated with the art program that was going on at the time there. And that's just where it all started. And then eventually it was, we don't have enough space. I'm sick of canvases all over my deck and in my basement. So let's get a space. So
why don't you explain to people that they don't have to be artistic, they don't have any experience, it's not intimidating, they can come in, just be basic beginners, right?
Absolutely. We have it wide open and our goal is to make people feel comfortable and inspired to be creative and not have to be, like, think about it. Like, if you've never done it before, it's the perfect opportunity. You don't have to invest in supplies. You just come in and socialize and have fun together and make memories. And that's the biggest thing we want, to promote the arts in a way that people can understand that, okay, yes, it's hard and it can be hard, but it's also fun and it utilizes a different part of the brain that they're not used to using. So okay. It's helpful all around.
So along with the art, you said sip. So do you guys serve wine, drinks, mm-hmm. food? What do you guys have here?
We have a limited menu. So we have flatbreads, artichoke dips, cheese platters, charcuterie boards. We have smaller options, snack trays for kids, hot chocolate, coffee, tea, and the wine and beer options we have is we've got some great Australian wines coming in. So I'm starting to bring in some of that. I've got a great vision out there for as we move forward in the business to promote and add culture to it. So we're introducing some Australian wines. We have the 19 Crimes, the Hope's End, and just a nice red and white varieties across the board for people to enjoy.
Where are you guys located?
We are actually in the Viking Plaza Mall. So I would say Midtown in Alexandria, Minnesota. And we're on the south side of the mall. No, the north side of the mall.
You're on the north side.
North side of the mall, yep.
Okay, so I'm getting ready to ask you your 5 rapid questions.
Okay.
They're not painful, I promise. Are you ready?
All right, I'm ready.
What is your favorite food?
Ice cream.
What is your favorite American word or saying?
Ufta.
If you were on a deserted island, who would you rather be with, Hugh Jackman or Chris Hemsworth?
Hugh Jackman.
And salt or sweat? Sweet. Salt or
salt
sweet?
Salt or sweat. Salt.
Perfect. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Leanne.
Of course.
This
thank
was
you.
Fun.
I hope you enjoyed this episode of Community Connections. If you own a local business and would love to be featured in one of my upcoming episodes, give me a call, Kassia Lueck at ERA Viking Realty.